So I sort of distilled down the primary change that we need to make in our economy from more to better. Better is clean air and more just societies and less inequality and better schools and everything. We already know about that. So I want to just tell you a few things about more. The first thing about more that I want to tell you is that it is not biologically and physically possible to run a system based on more forever. That we are already using more resources than the planet can replenish each year. So even if this soulless way of organizing an economy worked for you, which it works for very few people, even if you were one of them and you wanted to continue it, it's simply not biologically or physically possible. So we actually are forced to make this change. Second thing I want to tell you about more is that challenging the fundamental goal of more is actually a really serious thing. More sounds simple, but it actually describes one of the key characteristics of our hyper-growth-obsessed capitalism that we have today, which is the commitment to ever-expanding economic growth. It is the adherence to massive capital accumulation. Saying that we want to move away from more means you are challenging that, which really means that we're challenging modern capitalism. Is that some people in this country have a hard time letting go of more, not just the capitalists, but other people, because we sort of, there's something about more that resonates with the sort of American cultural DNA, that we conquer frontiers and we go to the moon and we don't have steady state in our DNA. So there's something about more that for many people feels aspirational and sort of, they're hesitant to give this up. With those, I would suggest a bridge conversation is to ask, well, more of what? Okay, you want an economy that still has growth, but growth of what? Growth of more and growth of asthma and diabetes and inequality and police shooting with black people, or more of good schools and clean water and a stable climate? The current way that we measure our well-being and our economy, as I said in that film, is just measures growth with no distinction between that growth which helps us and that growth that harms us. Fourth thing I want to say about more is that challenging the mythology around more is a way to force equity and justice into the conversation. And the reason is that the mythology that everyone can have more in this system detracts from the actual honest conversation about that we need to share. Now, often we talk about the solution to our overconsumption and overpopulation problems are to consume less. Some people clearly need to consume less. Some people are using way more than our share. But a lot of people actually do need to consume more. Right now, 1/6 of humanity, about 1 billion people, are chronically hungry. In this country, there are obscene levels of poverty, of kids who don't have enough to eat. Some people don't have roofs over their head and shoes on their feet. Even in this incredibly wealthy country, they actually need more. Now, if we're going to get current with the biological sciences and say that we can't all have more, and you see that some people actually honestly need more, there is only one ethical response, and that is to share. The final thing I want to say about more and better is that they weren't always at odds. There is a time in a country's development where more and better grow together like this. I remember as a kid watching the Little House on the Prairie episode where they got glass in the windows. Remember that? Like, that is great to get glass in the windows. That is a life quality enhancement. There are some times in our country's development that more actually does make things better. What happens is that you reach a certain point where the quest for more begins to undermine better. And begins to undermine better because it's breaking down our communities. It's polluting our air. It's increasing inequality. But somehow we got confused and we thought the goal was more. More should be a vehicle towards better. We don't sacrifice better for more. We sacrifice more for better. But it's important to realize historically that the more and better used to be together, they've split ways, and we've stuck with more. If we can turn that around and instead focus on better, then we can actually build an economy that puts people and the planet first and figure out how to meet everyone's needs in a way that's more healthy, more safe, and more just, and more fun, as David said, than we're doing now. Thank you.